Right, yeah, I'm getting trouble with my ants in my raised carrot beds. I don't want to use ant powder to try and kill them. Well, it hasn't killed them nowhere else. But I see Raff on Raff's, I think it's allotment garden. And he was using this stuff, so I don't know if you can read that. If you go on the internet, it's like organic. I think it's ground up shells or something. But I'm going to try this, see if this works. I'll show you the ants in my carrots, see what trouble I'm having. If you can see them. Nearly every pot in this one's got them going in. So I'm going to put some of this powder on. And just sit, I'll give it a few days and I'll get back to you, see if it's doing the trick. But it's getting in all the pots. Little buggers. That's my main trouble this year, is ants. So I've put the stuff in an ant puffer powder, so I'll give them a good blast. See if they like it. Give them plenty. I did find out they're coming in the bottom of the boxes. Right, I'm going to leave that. And I'll tell you if it does any good. Hello, welcome back to Nick's allotment. I'm just going to give her a quick walk around. I'm able to do a lot. I've been suffering with a bad back for 2 weeks. So I ain't done no videos, having a job. So these are the dahlias I had from Wilco's. Got there in the end. So there are all my dahlias. This orange one's here, meant to be a double, but it's a single. Shows you never know what you're getting. That's my dahlias. Because ants ain't growing a lot. On a good weeding. Everything wants a good weeding. This is me sparrowgrass. Gone to fern. Next are my potatoes, these are my earlies. I don't know, I think they're just that dry on the floor. I don't know if some of this is blight or not. I don't know if you can see. There's the odd ones I thought might have blight and I've pulled them out at the potatoes. There's another one there. I think that might be blight because you've got just going in the stem. See there, look. I'll cut that off now and having a fire so that can come off. Go on there for a ride. Right, nearly time to get the garlic up. I've got all my shallots up. I put them under the cloches, but I should take them down and put them in the greenhouse. These are the Avi Dunals, or whatever they call them. I'll give them another update when I move them all. These are Germore. Now, last year they were bigger than these. These were the Avi Dunals, and I was a lot bigger than that. I pulled the Avi Dunals up because they was getting too big. The onions, they don't look that fit and healthy, a bit like me. So I'm just leaving them in for a bit longer, see what happens. These are red barren, they don't look so bad. These are Tosca. I like the banana shallots, same as a Zabruna. The Zabruna don't look too bad. I'm just going to put me, I've been trying to have a bit of a burn up of my weeds. So I'm going to toast me blight. If it is blight. This is my sparrowgrass. This is the new stuff I've been opening last year. And it's still got sparrowgrass coming, look. My pumpkin. Just got a little pumpkin coming on. Don't look nothing special. This is my new sparrowgrass. It's supposed to be all male flowers. No flowers on it, but this is the other variety. It's got berries on, so it must have the odd female in it. And that one's Darlois. I'm getting a bit of the old, I don't know if you can see this. That's the sparrowgrass, where the sparrowgrass moss has been on. That's a caterpillar. Try to get something to see it. Sparrowgrass beetle, not moth. These are my, raspberries. They was new in the autumn. Trying to get to it focuses. I'll go in there, make it easier. Sunflowers are self-seeded. Just decided to appear in here. New raspberries, some have got the odd raspberries on. The strawberries are about over now. Got a lot of runners, but I'm going to cut all those off because I want it going back in the plant. All the energy to go back in there. That's them. Right, this is my wildflower patch. Came out. I think these are corn cockles. And all different flowers in there. Corn marigolds, as Sarah just said, if you could hear her. Corn flower, you can speak up, I won't bite you. More sunflowers, bird feeder. There's 3 kilos of sunflower hearts in there, and I filled that up Monday and it's empty now. That's goldfinches, love that. So look quite good, the wildflowers. Bees like it. Plenty of bees on there. There's my pond, you can just about see it. My solar power fountain, and got plenty of that duckweed coming in there. I think I might have to get rid of some of that. I'll leave it to go a bit more. Wants a bit more water put in there, it's drying up. This is a zinnia. That's what I put in. Sharing in my tunnel. Right, I showed you putting that powder down at Rafad. I'll show you what it is in a minute on the bag. It's supposed to get rid of ants, but it hasn't got rid of them. Contained. It's just contained them into the holes. I don't know if you can see. I don't know if it'll pick them up. They just don't want to come out of the pots. They're just stopping in the holes. Some of them work the way out, but if anybody out there have got like a got a way that I can get rid of the ants out of my carrots, because I don't want to put ant powder in because of me eating the carrots, so any organic way that I can get rid of them. Lucky they haven't got into these. These are my giant, the I think they're red intermediates, the long carrots. Sorry about the flickering around with the camera. These are cucumbers. They want a good watering, but it's just too hot to water at the moment, so I've got to come down tonight. Maybe chilies and peppers. That'll work, so I'll put the drippers on them. I haven't got the line set up on those yet. I think these peppers want picking, I don't think they go red. Quite nice. These are my other cucumbers. Don't know if you can see, the light looks a bit funny. These are mini munchies. Quite nice. That's a flower. Don't know what they're lacking in, they just look a bit of yellow in that. I think they want a bit of feed. Right, I'll get round the other side and show you the other. Right, this is me comfrey. It's nearly ready to change. It's about full. All I've done in there. Just put neat comfrey in the top. And then inside there, if I not get it up, there's a Coke bottle full of sand. So just let it down. I'll keep the top on, stop any water going in there. Yeah, the weight makes it. Just keeps it compressed so it rots quicker. Well, I don't know what rate to put that on. If anybody knows, it's 10 to 1 on when it's been diluted in water. So if anybody knows, let me know. These are a couple of bottles I've had out there already this time. I've got another one somewhere else. This is sheep daggins. Start watering the tomatoes on that. I'm using that at 10 to 1. This one's stinging nettles. That one's decanting. Put it over. Smelly vision. This one's all the bugs in there, don't know if you can see. Oh, that stinks. And then this was comfrey out off the side of the road. That probably wants decanting. That one's nettle. Nettle tea. That, the lone grain cloud in the sky. Rest all nice and white like cauliflowers. And there's a grey one. Right, these are my tomatoes. Coming on nicely now. I've had the odd sun gold, there's quite a few just starting ripening there. And I forgot to put the labels in what they was, each sort. I'll show you what else I've got. This is, I'll take this one off. It's like Botman rot, that's due to irregular watering. Causes that. I must remember to keep watering them properly. Grapevine. I've got one lot of flowers coming on it.
On the frost.
Because the frost had it to start with. That's the only bunch of flowers come, grapes. And I've got a magic little tomato here I found the other day. One with a face, look at that one. But he has got two noses. There's another one the other side. Perhaps he's two-faced. Here's my carrot and parsnip boxes. This is my parsnips. And a little box I've made. The old insect meshing on it. Parsnips are going well, they probably do with watering. These are Duchess. More parsnips in there. And these are my carrots, these are sweet candle. Job to spot in the light. That's a bit better, I think. Better by my eye. Coming along nicely. This is me swan neck gourd. Once tying up, just getting tied up. Before it gets any gourds coming on it. These are my bilotti beans. Just coming into flower now.
Pretty flower.
Bilotti bean flowers. These are runner beans, Enorma. Just starting to settle on them. Set. Yeah. After getting water, start watering them now. These are blue light, or whatever they're called. I think I've got a bit of untangling there to do. Get them going up the sticks itself. They are going up quite nicely. This cobra, they're just coming on. Got another gourd here. These were the parsnips I chitted, and I put these, if you remember, on one of my videos, and then I put them in compost. Start to come on. Didn't do too bad. Be interesting to see how they Come on, if it works, I'll do it again next year. Here's my carrots. I was nearly out of seed when I drilled them in, and then they run out up there. Those are sweet candle. These are my beetroot. They're just starting to swell up now, so I should probably do some water on them. My sweet peas. Coming on nicely. Need to pick them. Lone gladioli from here from years ago. Here's my sprouts. And then that's two rows of purple sprouting. Light purple sprouting. As you can see, the nice butterflies are getting on them now, so I'll keep my eye out for the caterpillars. Might put some of that powder on those. Right. All my little bamboo canes are out here. These are out my bee boxes. Kindly done by the Mr. Woodpecker. He's decided to empty them and have all my grubs out the bees. Well, I've got to put the wire on, but I think he emptied this before I got to put the wire on. There is the odd ones in there that's blocked off. You can see. He's been round the lot. These are some more sun gold tomatoes. I was going to throw them away, but I put them in here. They've come back. And there's a bird nest gourd there. This is my bench. I'll show you one day how I've done that. It all folds down out the way, what I made. I've got to give it a good clear out. So I'm going to plant my other bird nest gourd at the back. Right, I'm going to just show you some flowers on Joe's. All these roses come off two rose plants. What Joe does, when he prunes them, he just sticks the branches in the ground and he's got a new rose tree. That was that. And then his sweet peas, he didn't put them in till late, but it's a better show than any of mine. And if you can see in the right. Right, these are some plants I haven't got out due to me bad back. And I'm struggling, I can't get to water them. I don't know if I've got a trap nerve or what I've got. But I've got to have a, I can't have an MRI scan. So I've got to wait for a CT scan. But this is probably 2-3 weeks of weeds like this. This is all on my asparagus pots. Got this to sort out, but I just can't bend over. But never mind. I'd like to thank all my subscribers and new subscribers for watching and subscribing. And can't believe I'm nearly up to 300. I think I've got 290 now. Thank you to Nigel and Terry. They give me a couple of plugs and got where I am today. But not by the gardening. So hopefully I can catch up on it, commenting on everybody's videos. Just been lay up in bed. So I'll catch you next time, folks. Ta-da.